Hi guys, I've acquired something pretty interesting. I will be needing the vacuum cleaner though. We have an old Philco radio. I have no idea if it worked. I have no idea if it works. That's what's left of the power cable. I've taken the back cover off already. So if I just put you there for a moment, and you can turn this around. That's what's left of the outer insulation on the wires. And here's the actual inside the radio. Yeah, that's what I'm going to need. Because I recognise that style of cobwebs, so I know there is, or at least there was, a very large black spider in here. I can't see one. So, I'm going to take the vacuum cleaner to this in a bit and give it a clean. What do you have to say? Apart from all the dust and crap in there, it looks pretty clean. The tuner doesn't work at the front either. It goes down so far when you tune it, but then gets stuck. The bar on the scale gets stuck. I don't know if I want to have a go at fixing this. I'm actually dead certain I might be able to see a eight-legged friend in there. Can't see how you take the radio out. Does it just pull out? No, it is fixed in there somehow. And it says screws in the bottom. I don't know. I'll have a look at some point. Certainly be interesting if it does work. It'll also be great if it does work. Obviously, I'll put a new cable on it. But I wouldn't want to sell it in the condition it's in. If I can at least get it so it turns on and does something, it'll be worth a lot more to someone. But like I said, I've got to put a new power cable on, so this has got to come out. If I can do another time. I'm not sure what this is here. It's just got E and A stamped on it. I've got PU, I don't know what that is. External speakers maybe? And voltage selector, there's 200 to 229 volts or 230 to 250 volts. Yeah, I'll have to leave it on the one it's connected on. Yeah, apart from looking dusty. Oh, you gotta love that old smell. Nope, there's nothing come out of there, but that could be hiding in that speaker, so I'm going to have a good look with a torch. So I'm not very keen on spiders, especially the big black ones that make that type of webbing. So, yeah. I'm going to go and get my Henry vacuum cleaner in a bit. Yeah, I'd rather give it a check. It's a pity I couldn't find, modern cable, but on this old style, that would be great to put on this. I think that's what someone might have done before, because these are actually PVC wires. They're not fabric wires like these ones. So I'm guessing some work has actually been done on this radio at some point in its life. There's no way these wires are the original two. I can't see it, but the insulation on these speaker wires here are completely different to these. These are more modern PVC. And I bet if I actually strip the end back, there's going to be copper under there and not the silver coloured wire, whatever the silver wire was back then. Then again, I could just be chatting out of my ass, because I'm not an expert, so I'm sure someone on YouTube would correct me if I've got it wrong. How many tubes can I see in this? I only see four. Four, five, so it's a five tube set. And there's one, two, three, four, one just through there, five. And despite I watch Jim on YouTube, Jim Lindens, sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your last name, so I've probably got that completely wrong. I still haven't got a foggiest idea what I'm doing with one of these, and I can't even remember what this is. And there's two of them. So it will be, the other reason I want to actually take this apart is to have a look for myself what lies under here, capacitor wise and whatnot. And I've got a feeling I've got to undo some screws or bolts underneath here. What is it? Ooh, that's not a wooden cabinet. Yeah. So is it not as old as I might be thinking? Because this, I'm not sure if it's plastic, it could be Bakelite. I don't know, it feels pretty damn tough, whatever it is, but it's definitely not wood. It's clearly been stored, probably in a shed or something, looking at that. The culprit that made that web may not even be in it. He may have made the web and buggered off, if I'm lucky. Or it could be hiding in that bit there in the speaker, I don't know. I'm alright with little spiders, but not with big ones that make them. Big one can go up the vacuum cleaner. So, I don't know, do I do it in this video? Do I have a look underneath? Yeah. I'll see if I can get this bit out, and I'll turn the video back on when I have, so I shall return. Well, I've got the radio part out itself. A lot of dust in there. And there weren't as many cobwebs under here as I thought there was going to be. But, just looking at the power supply here, because that's what I need to change. Which would be as simple as desoldering from there and there and putting on a new one. I don't know. I don't know whether I'd give it to my stepdad to play with, or... But, as far as replacing components go, I can't see any replaced capacitors or resistors or anything like that. In fact, we've still got paper caps in here. So, looks rather grimy up here, doesn't it? It'd be interesting to know, you know, if it would work if I stuck power on this. To see if it would actually do something, but I don't think it will, to be honest. When it does go back together, we'll have to find four new of these, because, well, look at that. the heads were so rusted I couldn't get a screwdriver on them, so I ended up having to use a pair of mold grips. So I will be needing 4 new screws. Oh, I do love the smell of this. That old smell. Just turn the console around. Now that bit of glass out there, and that could have a clean. That can come out. Where's my chair? I'll take a seat on my chair. Okay, so I think that spring has slipped off the tuner. Yeah, it is actually rather stiff to pull on it. Now that might be why it's not working properly, because watch this though, if I pull on the string, the tuning post moves. If I do it like this, it doesn't move. So there's an issue there somewhere. This definitely needs to be cleaned. Hopefully I can, I see, there's just this metal bar at the top here that's clipped in. Ah, yeah, so if I take that out, I can drop the glass out and I can go and give that a clean. 3 light bulbs at the top. No idea what voltage they are. Plenty of dust. Even the tuning caps are full of... The tuning capacitors are full of muck and will have to be cleaned. Tubes! I haven't seen a tube radio in years. The last one I actually saw was one that my dad had. Actually. That's only a 5-pin. Better put that back in there. Before I forget which way round it came out. Is that a tube? I think it could well be. Power transformer. See, I have no idea why these works. How these work, rather. So it's got what? A big bunch of, these are actually fabric insulated wires, and there's 5. 5 going to a speaker. Can someone in the know perhaps enlighten me as to why there's 5? We only have 2 on a modern system. No magic eye on this. I'd love to figure out how old it is, but it's just got Philco at the bottom here. I can't find a... Not unless there's a chassis number on it somewhere. There might very well be a chassis number on here somewhere. Park you there for a minute. Turn this chassis into the light. Look on the back. There's a lot of numbers that... Oh, here we go. Found it. There it is. So what I will do later on, and I'll put it in the, either in the video title or the description, I'll Google the chassis number and see if I can find out how old this thing is. AB30560 stamped in the back. Well, I believe that would be the chassis number as it's stamped in. I can't find any other number anywhere. Now these cables aren't actually damaged, so I could actually connect this up to power and power it on. I wouldn't be able to tune it because the tuner doesn't work. But then again, considering all the gunk that's in the tuning capacitor, I'm not sure I'd actually wanna power it up yet. There's still a lot of dust in here, you know, and I bet these tubes get hot, so you know, probably burn off all this dust and start a fire, and oof, we'll have lots of smoke. What I need is an old toothbrush, but I can't currently get one out of my toolbox. Due to the fact that I can't currently get to the toolbox. So that'd be a bit of an issue. Anything like that, or even an old paintbrush, actually. Got an old paintbrush? I don't know where there was one. I was using it to clean my razor. There we go. I've lost the little brush to clean out my electric razor, so I've been using one of these. Cheapo paintbrushes, decorating brushes. Now, I'm no expert on these, as I've said before, but physically, apart from the dust, it doesn't look too bad in here. But like I said, I'm not an expert. I know nothing about these. You see all that flying out of there? See, this is why I want the thingy desk in the bedroom. But I was a bit too eager to make a video of this, so I know what would be better. An air compressor. A little air compressor or something similar to blow all the dust away. Right, that's my Lego table. It's going to need a very good clean down after this as well. Actually, you know, I've seen computers with more dust and fluff in it than this. I don't think this has ever been opened and cleaned out. Or if it's been opened, it's not been cleaned out. That is actually scary, you know, thinking about it, that I've actually found more dust inside a modern computer. And I think I got the majority of it out. Oh, no, there's still shitloads coming off here. La 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 la. We might leave these wires on just to test it, but to do a proper repair, I would have to fit a new cable. Right. Well, I've got a majority of it off anyway with the brushing method. But, not sure what I'm going to do with it yet. Is that actually supposed to look like that? Does anyone know? Oh, I see. These valves are, notched. That's alright then. At least that one was notched anyway. What about this one? I'll take that one out again. Yep, ah. So they can only be put in one way. That's alright then. Oh, just realised what these are. I can't remember what they're called. Oh dear. Should we have another look? One final look underneath before I turn the video off? And I might as well, just take the brush over it and tickle it. And just sit down again. So we get some of the crap of whatever these are. Not actually a lot. Well, I can't see many capacitors on here apart from that. Ye old paper cap there. I wouldn't be surprised if it is dead, and I'm not sure what that one is. Is that another one? Is that one of them moulded caps up here? No. Lots of resistors. I don't know what that one is. Is that a cap type of cap in there as well? Apart from that, what are these types of caps? Oh, there's another one here. Help! Oh. Okay, so perhaps choosing my Lego desk to do this on wasn't the best idea. Any help and advice would be appreciated. Well, I know from watching YouTube videos that I'm the cap to what you got to watch for on these. This one that I can't get off. Get off. No? There's actually a bit of cloth that's actually stuck to it. Bloody crap and fluff and ugh. Right. Set that back down. Not the right way. In fact, for safekeeping, I'll probably tuck it back into its, cabinet, case, whatever you want to call it. It's not wood, but I am intrigued to go Google the pattern number and, see what I can find. So, now that I know there's no creepy crawlies going to come out and get me in this, I'm a bit more comfortable working on it. Right. Yeah, we're going to need 4 screws for the chassis. Maybe 4 screws for the rear panel, as we've only got the 3, and I doubt we'll be able to match them up now. Okay, I think I better close my windows as well. That wind's getting a bit strong. And it's taking things off the window ledge, so, yeah. Let me just get up here before anything else. It's not over there, though. There you are, that my trailer's moved. Anyway. So, there we have it. Certainly the oldest piece of electrical equipment I have in this flat, so I would actually like to get it going. put these front knobs somewhere safe, don't I? Me, put something somewhere safe. I do that, then I forget where I've put it. Right. So, well, until I haven't put that in there properly, never mind. Get put back properly when it's all clean. The cabinet could do with a good clear. This looks like paint or something's been splashed all over it. Any advice on cleaning the cabinet up? Because ideally I would just like to get it into a working state, so at least powers on, turns on and does something, even if it doesn't work properly. So that was wedged behind the amp power and volume knob for some reason. I just think that would make a nice ornamental piece as well, actually. It's got long wave, medium wave and short wave. No, I really haven't seen a radio in years with those on them. It's all FM nowadays, isn't it? And AM sometimes. You don't get these old selections like you used to. I'm not sure what to... Wood white spirit or something be alright to clean this, as it's, well, I think it's plastic. It's not wood. Anyway, I'm going to say thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and there will be more to come on this one. We'll see how well a complete amateur can do at this, shall we? But in my eyes, you know, it's worth it. It would be worth fully restoring, I think, because I'm sure you could clean the cabinet up. It's all complete. I don't know what condition the speaker cone is in until I take the speaker out, but it looks fine. And apart from perhaps having to replace capacitors to make it work properly, and obviously putting a new power lead on it, I would say this would be a good restoration project. Obviously, I don't know the condition of the tubes, and I don't have a tube tester, so I'm literally going to be waving a stick around in the dark, so to speak. It's either going to work or it isn't. You know, they're the only two options, really. When I do put power to it, it will either work or it won't work. We won't know. But I'm sure this lead is a lot nearer than the... I could be wrong. It just looks... No, actually, I think I could be wrong looking at the end of that. Hang on a minute. Ow. Don't use teeth to strip wires back. It hurt. No, look at that. It's not copper wire, so that probably is the original cable. I'm going to pay the price for using my teeth now because I've got toothache. Well, I ache for a little bit now. I was just being too lazy, you couldn't be bothered to go over there and get my wire cutters. I have to say, for internal wires, they're in good condition, you know, they're not perished, they're not cracked, not that I can see or feel. It's just the outer fabric insulation has pretty much perished and fell off. And I'm guessing as the cable is only that long, not very long, that someone's cut it off at some point. Cut the cable, I mean. So, I don't know how much a replica cable would cost. So I'm pretty certain they can be bought. But to be honest, even if I took it to a car boot to sell it, you know, I wouldn't feel comfortable selling it with a power cable like that. That's just me, which is why I would at least, if I ever did decide to sell it, would at least want to replace that cable. So anyone else who buys it and wants to work on it hasn't got to worry about that and hasn't got to worry about an electric shock or anything coming off the cable. At least if I plugged it in and turned it on, I'd have some idea on what it doesn't do, if it doesn't do anything. So anyway, got rambling on again, didn't I? Yeah. So thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again in the next video.